Hello and welcome to this demo of what I call the best Excel template for inventory management or stock control. And why I call it the best is because it is a 7-in-1 template and it has all the ingredients that lets you monitor your inventory automatically. And here you get a beautiful dashboard view. So the 7 sheets are, you have the dashboard, which gives you the insights, your inventory value, your reorder count, your reorder value, a nice table for your purchase and sales trends. You have the inventory sheet, which is automated. If you see the columns with the blue headers, those are the ones which you do not need to enter manually. That's all automated. All you need to enter is the item number, the stock location, and the starting quantity. That's the first time when you start using the template. You have the item master, which is the list of all the products or items that you manufacture or you sell. And again, you get inputs like lead time, MOQ, and vendor count from the linked sheets. You have the PO register. So this is where you make an entry every time you update the stock of any of your items. And again, the values and everything gets calculated automatically. The sales order register. So every time your client orders something, you need to enter it here, and the details like the list price, the sales price, the amount gets calculated. And that gets reflected in your inventory register. Then you have the vendor list. You maintain a list of all the vendors that you do business with. And then you have your vendor master, which is a combination of your item and vendor master. So it tells you which items you buy from how many vendors. So let's say BM001 is your first product, a red stapler. So the vendor, you have two vendors for BM001. The MOQ for each is listed here. This helps you when you have to decide when to buy and from whom to buy. So whenever your inventory tells you that, okay, the product is due for reorder, you would go to the PO register, you would enter a new PO. So let's go ahead and let's do that. For example, if I go to the inventory right now, it says that my BM002 monitor stand is due for reorder. I have only 11 quantities in stock. My reorder level is 20, and hence it's showing that it's due for reorder. My MOQ is 45. So I'll go ahead and I will make an entry for BM002. And if you look at the dashboard right now, so every time you click here, it takes you to the main link sheet. Click on dashboard. And here you could see you haven't made any orders in the month of August, September, October. Today, as I record the demo, it's the 28th of October. So let's go ahead and let's make the PO entry. So you need to enter your PO code. This could be the code of your business. Then I need to order BM002. And now I need to go ahead and I need to check that how many vendors do I have for BM002. This is the process that you'll have to follow. So for BM002, again, I have two vendors, Zerbia Inc. and Pesto LLC. MOQ for Zerbia is 50, MOQ for Pesto is 40, cost per unit is 29.5 and 29. So I'll go ahead with Pesto LLC because the lead time is the same. It lets me order fewer quantity and at a lesser price. So I'll go back to my PO register, and here I'll go ahead and I will select Pesto LLC. My PO date is 28 October 24. And my order quantity was 40 is what I need to order because my reorder level is 20. So I'll go ahead and order 40. The unit cost was 29. So I'll go ahead and I'll enter 29. So this is my PO value. The order status right now is waiting because I just placed the order. So now if you go ahead, you will go to the inventory sheet, and here, if you go to the BM002, it still shows 11 because you've made the order. You have not received the order yet. But let's say you made the order maybe a few days ago just to check the video demo. Let's go ahead and let's change this date. Let's say it was 10th of October 24 and you actually received the order today morning, 28th October 24, and you received 40 orders. So the month is October. Now, if you go to your inventory level, now it's not showing reorder due because you've received. So your stock is updated 51. So you've so far ordered 40 quantities. You've sold 29. and this is the current value of your stock. And if you go back to your dashboard, it will get reflected here as well. So your October purchase order value is 1160, which is reflected in the chart here. And same thing happens with your sales register as well. So if you look at here, you have one order here for BM002. For 20 quantities is the order. It's WIP. Let's go ahead and let's mark it as dispatched. For example, first let's look at the dashboard. Your current sales for October is 449. Your inventory shows BM002. The current stock is 51. Sales order quantity so far is 29. Let's go ahead and let's mark it as dispatched. Dispatched today morning, 28th October 24, and we've dispatched all the required quantities. So we've made a revenue of 899. We go to the inventory sheet, and here you could see the order, the stock count has reduced to 31, sales order quantity is now 49, and your inventory value has also reduced to 914.5. if you go to the dashboard, you could see that your revenue field has also been updated, and you could see the update in the chart as well, and your reorder value has also reflects here. So your total inventory value as of today is 12,124. I've not added the currency here because people from across the world would use this template. So everything is in number format, but if you like it to be in your respective currency format, you could go ahead and make the changes. That does not really make any difference to how the sheet operates. You can enter your company name here. It gives you a counter of the number of items, your total due for reorder. You have the monthly table for how much you are spending on purchasing your products and how much is your sales revenue. So far, this company, the sample template, total purchase value is 4744 and 5,941 is your sales revenue, but you have your inventory value of 12,124. Here is a chart to represent your purchase and sales trends, and here is what I call a risk counter. It tells you the number of vendors that you have for each item. So for this company, which has 10 items, they have only one vendor for four of their items, and they have two or more than two vendors, three vendors for six items. So having more suppliers or more vendors for each of your products is a form of de-risking your business, because if you only have one supplier, if that supplier is struggling with their production or their business, that will affect your procurement and your business as well. So I have another template, which is a vendor management template. I will leave a link in the description. You could go ahead and you could download that as well. But that's a small risk counter. And here you have an item-wise description. So if you say BM002, there are two vendors, average cost per unit is 29.25, reorder level is 20, present stock 31, discontinued no. This is a drop-down. You could just go ahead and make changes and you get the updates here. So easy, that's just for an easy monitoring of your items here. So BM003 has been discontinued, so it says yes. So you could just go ahead and use a drop-down for a quick monitoring of your items. But what you really need is the dashboard to know the trend and the counter. The main tracker is the inventory tracker here, which is completely automated. It links with the other registers, item register, PO register, sales order register. So all you need to do is enter the item number, enter the stock location, and the starting quantity is when the first time you make an entry. And in case if somebody by mistake makes duplicate entry, for example, let's enter item number 6, then all the entries will get highlighted in red. That's an indication that this item already exists in the inventory. So what you're making is a duplicate entry. So a nice mistake proofing built in here in your dashboard. So very intuitive, completely automated. You could have different people responsible. So your inventory manager or inventory executive can enter details here. Item master, again, is to be managed by the inventory or the procurement team. PO register, again, by the purchase team or the accounts team. Sales register can be maintained by the sales team. The vendor list and the vendor master are to be maintained by the procurement team. So if you have different departments, managing different functions. Each of them can operate their respective sheets. And as a business owner or as a production manager, you get details completely in the inventory sheet and in the dashboard. So very nicely built, all the functions put together give you a wholesome inventory and stock control template for your small business. But this template is available in both an Excel version and a Google Sheet version at the same cost. The download link for both are given in the video description. Go ahead, download it, and take control of your inventory of your stock. In case while using it, if you have any challenges, or for your respective business, if you want to customize it, go ahead, mention that in the comment section, or you can visit my website and fill up the contact form. What you will get on purchase is this demo file, which we're seeing right now, and a blank inventory management file. You just need to go ahead and enter the start of the month from the date that you start using this template, and you're all set to start using this inventory management Excel template or Google Sheets, whichever version you choose to purchase. So go ahead, use it. Any challenges, do mention in the comments. If you need any other business template that you think will help other businesses as well, mention in the comments below, and I'll make the template, I'll record a demo, and I will publish it as soon as I can. So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care and be safe.